Nearby, the Tower of Liberty Hall rises above another land and another time. Each guest may roam the streets and experience the sights and sounds of colonial America 200 years ago. This oak in Liberty Square symbolizes the actual Liberty Tree of revolutionary times. And everyone here may almost feel the spirit of 76 marching across the land.
The day. Know all men by these presents, reposing special trust and confidence in the honor, fidelity, abilities, and good conduct of Amy and Carby, I do hereby bestow the titles of Daughter and Son of Liberty. To these recipients, I now present a copy of the Declaration of Independence.
The lucky boys and girls, chosen at random every day to be honorary sons and daughters of liberty, can take home a feeling of participation and personal pride in our American heritage. In Liberty Hall, there is to be found the most inspiring attraction of the Magic Kingdom, the Hall of Presidents. Here, in a dramatic presentation using a new film process and the miracle of audio animatronics, we pay homage to those immortal men who each in his own turn have guided this nation through perilous times.
This government must be preserved in spite of the acts of any man or set of men. Nowhere in the world is presented a government of so much liberty and equality. To the humblest and poorest among us, are held the highest privileges and positions. What constitutes the bulwark of our liberty and independence? It is not the frowning battlements or bristling seacoast, our army and navy. These are not our reliance against tyranny. Our reliance is in the love of liberty, which God has planted in us. Our defense is in the spirit which prizes liberty as the heritage of all men, in all lands everywhere. Destroy this spirit, and you have planted the seeds of despotism at your own doors. At what point, then, is the approach of danger to be expected? I answer, if it ever reach us, it must spring up among us. It cannot come from abroad. If destruction be our lot, we ourselves must be its author and its finisher. As a nation of free men, we must live through all time or die by suicide. Surely God would not have created such a being as man with ability to grasp the infinite, to exist only for a day. No. No. Man was made for immortality.
From the landing at Liberty Square, magnificent sternwheelers such as the Admiral Joe Fowler cruise leisurely through scenes of a growing country, the country of which Abraham Lincoln spoke so eloquently. Into a time of pioneer spirits and the songs of Stephen Foster. Along the way, there is a place that holds spirits of another kind, the lively spooks and mischievous goblins of the Haunted Mansion. Those who make it past this ghost-infested stretch of the river find a relatively safe landing at a village right out of the old Western Territory. It's the lusty atmosphere of frontier land, of trappers and hard rock miners, and a fast gun. The wildest foot-stompinest hoedown in town is the Country Bear Jamboree, with the zaniest entertainment this side of Cripple Creek. Let her rip, boys.
The Bear Band will play now in the good old key of G. Zeke and Zeb and Ted and Fred and Bear named Tennessee. Zeke's twanging on banjo and a tapping with his feet. A banging on a dish pan with a real old country beat. Zeb is sawing on the fiddle with a crooked hickory bow. When the spirit moves that ruin, he can make that fiddle go. Brother Ted is on the corn jug. Now I mean that bear can blow. He also plays the washboard with the handle of a hoe. And Big Fred's playing mouth harp. He played it kind of sad. He never took a lesson. He just picked it up from Dad. And little old Tennessee Bear is a featured on the thing. Sounds just like a guitar, but it's only got one string. Clap your hands and stomp your feet and try to keep right with them. One sure thing the Bear Band's got is real old country rhythm.
Run, 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 run